Lifespans of exotic pets are extremely variable, from over 50 years for some parrots and tortoises to a little over a year for some mice and hamsters. Many exotic pets remain healthy throughout their lives and only need nursing care towards the end. For pets with severe life-ending illnesses, such as terminal cancer, or those nearing the end of their natural lives, pet hospice care is important and beneficial. Exotic pets with severe illnesses or injuries may benefit from a stay in the hospital. However, hospital care is stressful and of less benefit for those needing end-of-life care. End-of-life guidelines were developed by the American Animal Hospital Association for traditional pet species such as dogs and cats. These guidelines can be extremely helpful for exotic pets as well. In general, provisions should be met for your pets: physical well-being, social well-being, and emotional well-being. If at any time these needs cannot be met, hospice care may no longer be appropriate for your pet. Physical well-being. Discomfort can be addressed with pain medications delivered by mouth, or in special cases, by injections. Local or topical analgesics can be helpful as well. Your veterinarian may also be able to offer therapeutic laser or treatments such as acupuncture. Be sure food and water are easily accessible and available in multiple locations, so it takes less work to find them. When pets cannot eat enough on their own, food can be offered by syringe using special products designed for this purpose. Your veterinarian can recommend products and amounts to provide optimal amounts of water and calories. The sick pet's environment should be safe and free of hazards, with non-slip footing, absorbent bedding, and single levels to prevent falls. Social well-being emphasizes social engagement with family and companions and mental stimulation. Pets receiving hospice care benefit from being kept with or near their human or animal companions. While it may seem natural to keep sick pets in an isolated area that's quiet with less activity, this can actually cause anxiety. Instead, house sick pets in familiar settings and work to keep that environment quiet and a bit more peaceful. If companions are too active, bully the sick pet, or take more than their share of food, consider housing them side by side so they can still see and interact with each other. Continue regular routines and opportunities to forage, which could be simplified for the ill pet. Emotional well-being emphasizes dignity, the will to live, and stress reduction. Many pets in hospice are too ill to groom normally and may accumulate urine and feces around the perineum. It's important to find a way to safely keep this area clean to prevent serious dermatitis or ulceration. Assess the pet's willingness to accept treatment and hand feeding. Treatment must not cause any more than mild stress. Try to maintain the pet's role in the household as much as possible. Watch for signs of resignation, withdrawal, or depression, signaling declining emotional well-being. An individualized hospice or end-of-life plan can be created with your veterinarian for critically ill pets based on that pet's needs and condition. As conditions worsen, it's important to review the plan regularly and be ready to adapt as needed. Some pets may have conditions that are not ideal for hospice care. These include pets with severe pain that is difficult to control with medications, or those with marked difficulty breathing where each breath is a struggle, even with oxygen. Be prepared to log items such as current body weight, amount of food consumed, urine and feces produced, and activity to help identify important trends. For pets at the end of life, at-home hospice care can be a peaceful and comforting way to provide necessary care and reduce anxiety. As long as pets are comfortable and well-being can be maintained, many pets can pass quietly at home. However, for those with discomfort that cannot be controlled or illnesses producing stress or anxiety, humane euthanasia is a better option. Another video in this series discusses the euthanasia process.